Hello everyone, welcome to the fourth episode of this series, The Era of VTuber, Building One with Python and Unity. So in this episode, we'll be talking about building some scripts for detection of various facial expressions, such as blinking, iris movement, and mouth movement. So just a reminder that all of the source code can be found in my GitHub page, and you're welcome to check it out here later. We'll be introducing these features. The first one is eye aspect ratio, which will be used for detecting the blinking one. And you may use the auto blinking script as well as using the eye aspect ratio for detecting the blinking, like in the Unity 3D model. The second one is the iris detection, which will be used to stimulate the iris movement of the 3D model. So some of the 3D models and 2D models support this one, and you can use this function. The first one is the mouth aspect ratio, which will be used for speaking, although it can be replaced by a volume detection program and control the mouth opening. I think this will be much better as well, and it's supported by the face mesh library as well. The fourth one is the mouth distance, which will be used to control the form of the mouth. So like if you're doing an O shape, then you can display it as well as in the live 2D or 3D model. And the last one will be the breathing, which will be used in the live 2D only, depending on whether this parameter is given in the live 2D model or not. So we'll get started into the first parameter, which will be the eye aspect ratio. So all of the script of such feature is in the facial feature script here. So the facial feature script and the eyes class, which is the enum, will be used to separating the left and the right eyes. Okay, so the first one is the eye aspect ratio. It is based on this paper, which is using eye aspect ratio to enhance fast and objective assessment of facial paralysis. So here in this paper, they are using the DLIP 68-point landmark to conduct the detection by detecting the eye blinking and as well as facial paralysis. And this is the formula here, but we're also applying this formula into other applications, like detecting whether the driver is in a nap or it is not concentrating on driving. And it can be done by using this eye aspect ratio and other facial landmark detection program. However, since we are not using the DLIP library, we have to match these landmark points to our face mesh model to select the corresponding points or something landmark points or the face mesh model. Luckily, we have the visualization of live 2D of the face mesh model here, and you can see it is the left eye, I guess, and it is the right eye here, and you can select the points according to the ID labeled right here. So the points are selected in my script. You can find the picture in the face mesh and face mesh website and click the UV visualization here. As so these are the formulas, we'll explain it later. We'll calculate the distance between some landmarks and dividing by the distance of the side of your one eye of the end of your one eye. So it's the 33 and 133 here, this image distance, and we'll multiply a factor here. So the factor is this lemma is, I guess, is the tip of the eyebrow, and the last lemma is the bottom of your nose, and we're also choosing the corresponding parameters according to the UV visualization picture provided by the face mesh here. Factor will be served as a amplification factor for the eye aspect ratio. So here, jump to the script. Here you can see in the eye aspect ratio, we pass in the coordinates, the pixel coordinates of all 468 landmarks, and as well as indicating whether your calculating eye is for left or for the right eye here. So these will be the values that we'll be using here. And you can see here, like here, it will be selecting the corresponding points. And here we'll be setting the corresponding points for either left or right eye. Then here will be the formula by adding the Euclidean distance of these landmarks and dividing by the Euclidean distance of the length of the image distance of the side of your eyeball. and we'll multiply the amplification factor and return the eye aspect ratio. And it can be used for light blinking or even single eye is supported in some of the live 2D models. Okay, so that's the first part. And in the controller, so like here is 2D controller, the Hioi controller here will be in the eye blinking one here. We'll apply the values, and so before applying we have to send the value for the TCP connection. And so and since there is some mirroring issue, we will, so if my left eye is blinking, and so in the live 2D one will be the right eye of the live 2D model, some threshold here to have a better movement. So like, so it is used to control the opening and the closing. So if the eye aspect ratio is below the minimum threshold, then it will be closing. So if the eye aspect ratio is higher than the threshold, then it will be opening. And so you multiply as well, and you apply the parameters, apply the eye aspect ratio to the parameters. So the same is in the Unity Giant controller here, eye blinking. But however, in the Unity Giant, you can't control individual eyes. Instead, it controls both of the eyes. So here we take the minimum eye aspect ratio of the left and the right here and apply the same one. So you clamp it between the threshold, which can be adjusted in the inspector. And here you take, and here you do some conversion here. And there's something special in the Unity Giant controller is you can see that from the auto blink script, when the ratio is, so the ratio is in range of 0 to 100, and when the ratio is 20, it is halfly closed, the eye is halfly closed instead of a linear ratio in the live 2D one here. So here you can use some Desmos quadratic regression to find the parameters and to apply it to the eye aspect ratio here, get the corresponding parameters in range 0 to 100 and apply it to change the blending of the corresponding mesh layer in the Unity Giant here. So here the IEDF and the ELDF is the corresponding shader of the eye blinking controller. Okay, so this is the first part, and the second one will be the iris movement here. So to detect the iris movement, we're using some image processing library in the OpenCV here. So I referenced some of the script and some YouTube tutorial to come up this iris movement. So here, only live 2D model supports, because Unity 3D Giant doesn't support this feature, or although it supports, but the effect isn't look good. So I don't use it in the 3D models, but some of the 3D models support it and you can apply it as well. So here there are three main steps. The first one is to find the region of interest, which is the eye, using the lens mask. And the second is to apply some filters, like you apply some Gaussian blur, or you change it to gray, or even you apply some threshold filters to get the contours and the image pixels of the coordinates of the contours, and you return the ratio of how the iris is located in the eye, right? So whether 0 to 1 the ratio is. So we jump to the code here, facial features, the detect iris. So you pass in whether you are detecting the left eye or the right eye, and you pass in the mask should be, you pass in the image and you pass in the lens mask here, using the mask parameter. So return four things. The first one is the x coordinates of the iris. The second one is the y coordinate of the iris. So this will be the pixel coordinates. And the third one is the ratio. The fourth one is the ratio of how the iris is positioned in the eye. Right. So 0 means totally left and 1 is totally right. And 0 of the y is totally top and 1 is totally bottom. So we declare some of the threshold for the thresholding function of OpenCV. So the first one, we have to create a mask by creating a contour to find the eyes and using the eyes indicates the landmark ID declared right here. Okay, then you apply the fill polygon function to draw the region out and using the bitwise conversion to plot the corresponding value. And then you apply the filtering, so you first convert it to gray and you apply the Gaussian blur, and then you threshold the image so that only the pupil will be your interested region. And at last you find the contours, find the largest one and draw the contours out, and then you get the contour ball and get its XY position and get the centered position. And you can uncomment these lines to have a look about the image detected by the filter. And last you calculate the ratio. And so you return these four values, and the most useful will be the X ratio and the Y ratio only. So if there's some error and you return 0, 0 and right in the middle of the eye white. So that's the second part. And you jump and we jump to the controller. So in here the iris movement function will be responsible for controlling the iris of the live 2D model. So here, since it doesn't support the individual iris control, like in 3D model, it doesn't support individual eye blinking feature, we're taking the average of the iris position, and then we clamped it to the ceilings so that it has a better and more significant result on the live 2D avatar. And the parameter range is -1 to 1, so we multiply by 2 and -1 to shoot the value into the range. And here we pass the calculated value to an activation function to create a smoother effect when the iris is near the center, and a more obvious result when the iris is near the side of the eye white. So it is the cubic function, just a simple cubic function, and you can uncomment these two lines. And lastly, you apply the value to the corresponding parameters. So that's all for the iris movement, and next we will jump to the mouth aspect ratio. So here is the formula that we use for calculating the mouth aspect ratio, and is created by this guy here. So here you have some introduction, and you're calculating the drowsiness of the driver. So here you have the mouth aspect ratio, and this is the source. This is the source. So you get some of the points, and like in this picture, it is using the DLib library, and like in the eye aspect ratio, we have to convert these points to our face mesh model. So you take some of the points here, and the conversion is done in the script. So let's jump to the code. So it should be the mouth aspect ratio. So first we select all of the 8 points that's shown on the formula, and then we just apply the formula. So here the norm is the image distance. It is the image pixel distance. And we return the aspect ratio. And so we add 1e-6 to prevent any zero division problem. So we can apply the mouth aspect ratio to our both live 2D and 3D controllers. So in our live 2D controller will be the mouth opening. So like in the previous parameters, we also clamp it to some of the threshold to create a better visual effect. And we calculate the ratio as well. And at last, we apply the parameter, we apply the value to the corresponding parameters. Similar steps are also done in the UDC jar controller, which is the mouth moving function. But here, instead of 0 to 1, its range is 0 to 100, so we multiply it by 100. And you apply the ratio on the corresponding blending shader on the Unity DOM. So it should be the here. So I have to drag. So the second one is here. So you can see the mouse is moving when you change the parameter. So to drag the corresponding also, I guess you can't see it. So you have to drag the corresponding mesh to the mesh render to the parameter. The parameter is better. Okay, move it back right here. Okay. So the last one will be the calculating the mouth distance, which control the shape of the mouth to create like O shape or even the unhappy one. It's optional to enable it. So in the Python part, it's just calculating the mouth distance between two landmarks located on the side end of the mouth, like here is 78 and 308. And the value is sent to the Unity site using the TCP again. So like here, the facial feature, we have a separate function to calculate the mouth distance. It's just as simple as it looks. And here in the live 2D one, we have a mouth form, which received the information from mouth distance, and we like the previous parameters, we clamped it first, and its range is -1 to 1, we convert it to -1 to 1 from 0 to 1, and at last apply the parameters. Okay, so I think that's all, and I hope I do not miss any important parts. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment it. Well, feel free to comment in the comment section. And I hope these explanation videos allows you to grab this concept better and be able to alter the code as well to suit your purpose. So depending on the reaction of the series, maybe I will stream some extra episodes to talk about the UI system and the safe load system in the Unity of my project. But I think the code is okay enough to understand, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, and share the video to your friends, and make sure to stay safe and stay well in mid of the pandemic, and thanks for watching.